Yes. Y'all already know it's Wednesday. Another wild and crazy edition of the Man Cave. I'm your host, Cal Williams. And you know, joined by my other host, Mr. Gator himself. Gator, what it do?
What's good, man? What's poppin'?
Ain't nothing, man. You know, long week, you know, weekend was all right, but you know, I'm real, you know, relaxed when I'm in the cave. You know how we are, we in the cave.
Sure, I know that's right. I've been celebrating, so.
Oh, that's what I'm told. What you been celebrating, bruh, brother?
Bruh, I got the call about the job. I've been waiting.
Oh, you got that bag. You got that bag coming.
They know. They listen to the breakdown. We talk about it in here sometimes. Boy, I've been struggling, waiting. Like, this is what I need. And the money, well, I already been told the money straight.
Mm-hmm.
And right now, it's like, the lady basically told me I pretty much got the job.
Okay.
But she just can't flat out give it to me. I got to go through the proper process. So
you got the job, but she just got to make sure it looked like, you know, there was other candidates, basically.
When she called me and she said, so I'm going to need you to go on the site and fill out this application. And she said, I got a guy that's leaving in 2 weeks. That's basically what she told me.
Okay.
She said nothing else. She said, just go on there, fill out the application. Uh-huh. Let me know when you did.
Okay. There you know go. That's what I'm talking about.
You know how quick I went and filled that mug out?
I bet. That's right.
Bruh, but the security applications ain't no joke. Uh-huh. I forgot. It was one section. One section had like 50 questions. I'm like, oh, my God.
Yeah. That sounds about right.
Bruh.
That sounds about right.
I had forgot all about this. And next question is like 38 questions. Uh-huh. I'm like, oh.
Asking you all kinds of stuff that is like, man, if I answer this a certain way, I might not get this.
I know a lot of people, especially with me working, I get complimented all the time. They be like, you different. Like, I used to work at extended stay, and them are like the hotels that they make into little places where people can stay for long periods of time, seven, like a week or, you know, months. Some people pay like monthly rent to them, but it's more expensive, you know, because it's a hotel and you got everything there already, like an efficiency, basically. But man, them jokers got rid of me, and them people were so, they was talking mess at first.
Uh-huh.
They got rid of me. They were so mad. They was like, please come back. No, man.
I bet.
I ain't coming back. Yeah.
That's right. I ain't know how to act. Y'all ain't know how to act when I was here. Now y'all want me back. Nah.
Y'all ain't know what y'all was going to be missing.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Not my fault.
That's normally how it is.
Dude.
That is normally how it is.
Them jobs are headaches, though, anyway. So, whew. Man.
Hey, on to the next. On to the next bag. That's all.
Yeah,
on to the next bag.
Yep. Exactly.
Yep. But, I mean, let's just chime in a little bit. Let the listeners and, you know, everybody know what we're going to talk about tonight. You know, we're going to go a little deep in the bag, you know, tonight. Go a little deep. You know, we're going to talk to our female listeners tonight. You with that, Jacob? How that sound?
Now, you know I'm with that. Out of everybody that do shows on Tone Deaf Network, I'm the one that they always say be talking to the women.
I mean, that's why I had that issue. That's why
even the women that do shows, they
they be like, "Word, you for real? You right?" They be like, "Yeah, Jacob, you know, you talk to the ladies, you know." And they just be like, "Yeah, Calvin, you just be talking, man. You just be You know, the stuff that could stuff that come out of your mouth, Kyle, man.
Ooh.
Like what? I'm saying. Hey, I say what people don't want to really say.
Exactly. There it is.
You know. But we're gonna talk to our female listeners tonight, you know. But we're gonna, of course, talk in the man cave way. As we
yes,
do.
Sir.
You know,
yes,
so
sir.
Tonight's topic, like I said, we're gonna dig a little deep into the bag, but you know, we want you to also catch the jewels that we're gonna swing your way, the man cave way. So tonight's topic is he really committed to the relationship, or are you just convenient to him?
Ooh.
Uh-oh. Disclaimer. I don't want none of y'all guys sending letters to Tone Deaf Network about me tonight, because I'm finna be real and you might feel like I'm stepping on your feet.
Well, send them to TDRmancave@gmail.com.
I'm just saying.
Hey, if you got
hey,
eight
Tone,
brothers.
If you listening to this, I need to proofread everything.
You got to proofread? You got to proofread everything?
Let me quit, man.
I mean, listen, hey. If you have any concerns about anything that Gator says,
they know,
or anything
they
that
know,
Cal says.
I don't got a problem giving out my own, you know, email. Send me a letter.
Yeah, woo, send it.
Hey, your
send
boy,
it, please.
I'm trying to get published right now, and
uh-huh.
I know I'm finna get a lot of hate. So
hey.
I'm already ready for it.
Uh-huh.
I'm ready for it. You know, send the word.
Well,
I'm
send
just
the word,
saying,
like
that.
I said,
send the word.
Send it. Send your concerns to TDR the man cave @gmail.com, and we'll address it. But yeah, I mean, the topic tonight. It's a very strong topic. It's a topic that a lot of women tend to ignore or give an excuse.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they tend to ignore or they give it an excuse, and they
mm-hmm.
justify it, and you know, in certain ways that they do. It's just is what it is. But I mean, tonight we want y'all to really look deep and look deep into yourself and ask yourself, is he really committed to the relationship, or are you just convenient to him? That's simple.
Mm-hmm.
So mm-hmm. I mean, it's only right that we got to start with the love doctor, Gator himself. You know, I mean, Gator, shine some light on this. You know, we got to start off with you. You know, the connoisseur. And,
I mean, me personally,
mm-hmm.
I kind of feel like it depends on what's going on in the situation. Like,
mm-hmm.
there's some stuff that I hear about that I be just like, wow, that's what's going on, and it's not. A lot of people feel like, well, especially guys, I be hating, and that ain't it. It's just, like I said on the breakdown, I say it all the time, it's just that I'm tired of being the bad guy.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, we get that demeanor from other
oh, yeah.
people. You have to come in behind certain ones
yeah.
that then did this and they did that, and it's like...
Yeah.
Oh my God! I gotta clean
yeah.
up behind this joker.
You gotta play cleanup.
I'm tired, bro.
Gotta play cleanup.
It's tiring.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta build the woman back up because she done been toe down.
And then toe down some more.
I do that.
So let me ask you, like, what is it? What is some signs for a woman to know if that man is really dedicated to the relationship, or is she just convenient to him? Like, what are some signs for a woman to look for? For you. Like, what's some signs for a woman to look for? The ones that really don't know. Let's talk about the ones who really don't know first. The ones that really don't know and really think that man is committed to them and love them and all in the relationship. What are some signs for the woman that doesn't know to look for, to know if that man is really committed to the relationship, or is she just convenient?
The top sign to me, that's just to me, is that if he will, or if he won't give you his last, that's probably a sign.
It's probably a sign. 9 times out of 10. Yeah, he probably just dealt for convenience. If you in need, now.
Okay. That was my question.
Yeah, there are those that's out there that just, they're just trying to get it any way they can.
Yeah.
And they know they don't need it. They know they don't need it. They just trying to get it. Let me see if he
Yeah, they just trying to ask. They just want to see if you're going to give it.
Yeah. Like, man, you know you make more money than me.
Exactly.
You won't let me borrow nothing.
Right. I can't get nothing from you.
Let me see if I can get it, though. Let me see. Let me check this out. Let's see. Because you got those that's out there that do that on the regular.
Oh, of course.
And then throw it in their face. Oh, you not going to give it to me? Oh, see, that's why. Like, what? Really?
Oh, yeah, of course. Of course. You know that.
But that's a sign, though, for real, for real. Like, if that joker would give you his last, for instance, a man's tired. He just came home from work. Ladies, you done cooked him a beautiful meal. It's just lovely. He done got cleaned up. He done came, sat down, and eating his food. It's his last little piece of chicken on the plate. And he finna offer it to you. You know that man, Hulk. Come on, man. We ain't finna get no food away too easily, man.
Right. Right. We ain't.
I'm just saying. And it's not because I'm big dude. I'm just saying, little man, do it too. I'm just telling you right there.
Just saying. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yep. It happens. It definitely does happen, man. It definitely does. So if a brother won't give you his last, that's definitely a sign. If it's like
it's
he said, if he's hesitate,
it's a sign. Yeah, it's a sign. A lot of women don't notice that, but it is. They just take it as, oh, well, you ain't just it. Nah, bro.
Right.
A guy that loves you regardless.
Now, okay. So let's say if he's in a situation where he can't give his last, would that be taken as he's not as committed as the woman is because his situation doesn't allow him to actually give her as much as she may need?
Now, honestly, I don't think so. I really think that the woman already knows, bro.
Right.
They already know. Unless it's a situation where y'all ain't communicating like that. That's the only way she wouldn't know what was going on. Women know what's going on. They play like they don't. They play Boo Boo the Fool a lot. That's another test. Just to see if you're going to come out and tell them what's really going on. But 9 times out of 10, they know. I'm just saying. Especially with the women that I have associated with, had communications with, and I do this all the time. And the only reason I open myself up to it is because, well, when I started, majority of the women that came talk to me were my friends until I started doing shows.
When
I started doing shows, it broadened, you know, it got bigger and everything. But usually it was just my friends coming to me saying, yo, this is what's going on in my relationship, blah, 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 blah. I ain't there to down your man. That's not that ain't what I'm doing. Right. If anything, I'm trying to repair the situation unless it's seen that it's unrepairable. Now, there are certain situations. Me personally, I don't see no way around. Like, if he's putting his hands on you.
Yeah, that's a no-go. That's a no-go.
He's talking to you all crazy. To me,
that's a no-go.
If he's talking crazy, and he's talking to you like you ain't nothing, the only thing left to do is put his hands up. That's it. That's basically it. I got a situation with a friend right now that says she's been with her man for so long, and I'm talking about 10 plus years,
and they ain't together, but they together.
Okay. Okay.
And she basically came to me and says, I don't know what to do. It's got so bad to where we don't even sleep in the same room.
No.
And this has been going on for, let's just say it's been over a year. It's been going on.
Right.
And I was like, what? Wait, it's like that? Yeah.
Right.
Oh. Ooh. Where he don't even sleep in the room with you?
Right.
Like I said,
that's bad.
I'm not one to talk down about men. I don't do that.
Right.
But hearing what's going on, it's like, yo, I don't know if that's repairable. Y'all should try to go. But the problem is there are people or specialists that are placed out here for us to go to. And, like, I'm talking about counseling right now. Different people, even pastors or those that have gotten degrees in counseling and stuff like that. If he want to repair that relationship and he wants to be in that relationship, he'll be all for it. But there are some dudes that just ain't with it. They don't see nothing wrong with the situation. And that's what's going on right now. I'm like, oh, it's like that. And you know, you hate to hear that about your friends. Like, dang, I didn't know you was going through that.
But, right.
I don't know. It's like I said, I ain't going to say that there is no way to repair it, because there is a way. But if both parties aren't willing to try,
then that's an issue.
And I only speak on that because I know about that. I've been through it. That's the only reason I speak about it.
Right.
So,
that's what it boils down to.
Yeah. And if it's a lot of situations that I don't touch because I haven't been there. So I don't know. But that one, I know about.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So, yeah. That's just my personal opinion. Send your mail to...
right. Most definitely. I mean, that's... Hey, send your mail. Like we said, you got an issue, send your mail, please. We'll talk about it. We'll definitely talk about it. I mean, it happens. I mean, like if both parties is not willing to work on it, then it really doesn't make sense, because one person can't fix the issue.
Exactly.
One person can't fix the issue. It's bigger than just one person.
And I know a lot of guys, especially speaking in marriage. And there are some that are common law that I still look at as marriage because they done been together so long. I don't know too many guys that's just going to throw their marriage away. Unless something, like, it's something drastic, something else is going on outside of that marriage. They're going to try to do everything in their power to fix it. But if they don't want to, and they don't want, I don't want to hear that. No, I ain't going to no counseling. I ain't doing none of that. Well, we can just go talk to pastor. No. We don't need that.
Nah, can't do that.
Exactly. That's a problem.
Exactly.
And that ladies is the same way. The same way for the ladies, though. Because in my situation, I was the willing party. So it goes both ways.
It does. It really does. I mean, like, and if you're not willing to put in that work, it really doesn't make sense. Really doesn't make sense. And the thing about it is, like, to touch a little more on the topic tonight, it's like, I've seen a lot of women that deserve better give their man an excuse. You know, oh, well, you know, he didn't come to the family gathering because, you know, he was tired. He works a lot. Or, no, he didn't come out with us to the birthday party because, you know, he had to get rest. You know, he doesn't really deal with that side of the family like that. You know he's antisocial. It's like, what? Huh? I get it. But at the same time, when you in a relationship, sometimes it's about sacrifice. Sometimes it's about stepping out of your shell, stepping out of what you normally do and sacrificing that for the person that you love. So, you know, that's why I said tonight's show is dedicated to the women. A lot of women give excuses, you know, to bullshit that men put them through. And this is the man cave, so we're going to keep it real. You know, it's never bias in here. Yeah, man, we put women through bullshit sometimes. We do. Yeah, we do. But the difference between a man and a boy, you know, from my brother Gator, is a man fesses up to when he putting a woman through bullshit and he writes his wrong. A boy is going to give it an excuse after excuse after excuse to the point where one or two things is going to happen. Either that woman is going to start to believe that bullshit ass excuse, or she's going to start helping him cover up his bullshit ass excuses so they both can save face to everybody else that may be looking at the situation crazy.
Ooh, and I didn't see that.
You know, so
that's just like my boy would say, that's beyond me. And if you're on social media, you know who I'm talking about.
Oh yeah, I know.
That right there is beyond me, man. I don't understand it. Like, and I've seen it a lot, especially with dealing with, like, doing shows about relationships and stuff like that, and women talking to me, I hear that a whole lot. And I'd be like, how? I don't understand. And the kicker would be, this is the kicker, Chad. The kicker would be the woman that they don't want to do it with. To me, gorgeous woman, wonderful mind, she's really hurt about this situation, and you could tell. Like, I've had a friend that was going through that, and for her to cry to me, it killed me. I was like, oh, I hate that. I couldn't deal. But luckily for her, that situation turned around because he was willing to do any and everything to make that relationship work. And I think it had a lot to do with that situation with the age difference, because he's a whole lot younger than she is. You know, we look at stuff differently anyway. Mm-hmm. But when you're younger, you really look at stuff differently because you ain't experienced a lot yet.
And you haven't.
Her maturity, shoot, when she told me how old she was, she threw me off. I was like, dang, for real? And you couldn't, like, for real, if you see her pictures or anything on social media or whatever, you wouldn't believe it. You see her in person, you wouldn't believe she was as old as she is.
Mm-hmm.
And I mess with her all the time because I be calling her ma'am. But that's just the instigator in me.
Right. I feel you know. Exactly. It happens. Listen.
And she know it too.
Right. It happens, man. Hey. But I say this, like, women, a lot of women, like you said, we think differently, but there's also the women. Now, we spoke about the women out there who don't really know that guy's not committed. Now, let's talk about the women out there that know that man's not committed. But they pacify him.
They stay.
And they pacify him.
I was told.
Why is that?
I was told by more than one woman. I was going to say a group of women, but they wasn't all together when I heard this. But I was told by, I've talked to quite a few women over the years.
Right.
I'm in my 40s, but I ain't up there yet. But I've been told.
Forever young.
That,
there are those women out there
mm-hmm.
who, let's say, they don't want to be by themselves.
Right.
They have this relationship. To them, it's good.
Right.
When they single, they're uh-huh. miserable.
Mm.
I know okay. a lot of women that's not like that, but there right. are women that are like that. They're like, oh,
yep.
I don't like being by myself. As a man, I was like that at first. Until I was like, you know, I'm going to take the opportunity to get to know myself again.
Right.
And I started doing stuff by myself like a lot of women do. Like,
uh-huh.
it's nothing for you to go to the movie theater and see a woman sitting by herself. Or go out to eat and there's a woman sitting over there by herself. They uh-huh. do it all the time now.
They do it. Yeah, all of but, now.
You know. Yeah, now.
Now, before, you want to catch a woman dead. You want to catch a woman by herself nowhere.
Well, you know who we can thank for that.
who can we thank for that?
Miss Independent.
Yep. Yes. The B, Queen B. Queen B. Queen B.
Because I ain't going to lie, dude. Until she did that song, I ain't seen so many women by themselves. And loving
Yo,
it. Like, this
she sparked a whole... She sparked a crazy movement.
Be like, what? What you mean?
She
all
sparked
these
a
women?
Crazy movement. The movement she sparked was bananas. Like, she actually made women want to be by themselves.
That's what I'm saying.
She made a series, and she made a series of songs like that. Ms. Independent,
bruh.
A whole bunch of them, man.
Bruh, I'm telling you. So it's like, yeah. I don't know. I'm starting to see more guys doing that too, which I didn't see that a lot. But guys
see, we
do it too. But
we're doing it for a different reason now. See, women doing it in a sense of, fuck that. I don't need no man. I'm independent. I got my own money, my own car, my own this. Women doing it because of that shit. We doing it because we tired of the bullshit. We doing it because a lot of these women out here, man, they mentally bipolar, man. Like, we tired of the bullshit. Like, that's why we doing it. So we on some shit like we actually want to be alone sometimes because, like I say all the time, the scales is not unbalanced no more. The scales is even now. So
yeah,
just
yeah.
like we used to, we put women through a lot of bullshit in the past. We put them through a whole bunch of bullshit. The scales now is even, man. Women put men through a lot of unnecessary bullshit now. So
yeah. Yeah.
You know. We on some shit now where we like, fuck it, man. I ain't dealing with this dumb shit. I'm going out by my damn self.
That's how it be.
You know?
Especially
so,
now. You sure right.
It's different, man. It's totally different. This day and age is different, man. We ain't dealing with that shit, man. We voluntarily being single.
Absolutely. Nothing.
And when we find one that we think is a good catch, we got a list now. Before,
man,
before we had no damn list.
Man, talk about that.
We got a list. We got a list now, damn it. We pull
believe
up.
Me. Believe mm-hmm. me, dog. Go ahead. Go ahead.
No, I'm just saying, man, we pull up. We pull up with the pad. Like, all right, so let me ask you something. Do you cook? Do you clean? Yeah, so what's your 5-year plan? Where you see yourself in 5? Like, we asking questions that we ain't never even cared about before.
Shoot, that's the question we used to get at.
Exactly. Yo, what's the craziest question a woman ever asked you? Like, when like during the dating stage, getting to know you and stuff, what's the craziest question you ever was asked?
Craziest question.
Craziest question that had you like really stumped, like, huh?
I've been asked a lot of crazy questions. Oh, you know what?
Mm-hmm.
I think one of the craziest, well, I don't know if it was crazy, it was more like
mm-hmm.
unexpected, was me trying to get to know this young lady.
Okay.
And
for some reason, she just wouldn't give me the time of day.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't understand it. But
mm-hmm.
this is in my bouncing days at the club.
Mm-hmm.
She was always in the club and staring.
Okay.
Like, you know how women say men be staring at them and
yeah,
they want to
yeah.
approach them? That's
mm-hmm.
what she was doing to me. So I took it upon myself, like,
mm-hmm.
okay, maybe she's a little afraid to step to a man, or
mm-hmm.
it's not, you know, looked upon. Like, oh, well, this been a couple of years ago. This been about 10 years ago.
Right.
12 years. Something, yeah, it was a little bit more than 12. But I was like, I'm going to step to her.
Mm-hmm.
And I did. And the first thing she was asking me,
mm-hmm.
and it threw me completely off. It was like,
mm-hmm.
so, you ever been with two women?
Mm.
Lady,
okay.
I just met you.
I just met your wife. The hell, what?
You're a whore.
Yeah, sure, lady. See, I see now, my dumb ass would have took that as an invite. I'd have been like, what?
See,
you trying
I
to get
say,
it popping?
See, I found out later on.
Okay.
I talked about this on the show.
Yeah.
It was.
Wow.
I didn't know that. The reason that she wouldn't give me the time of day for
okay.
a period of time
mm-hmm.
and me
mm-hmm.
trying to talk to her was because
right.
she was in a relationship with a woman.
Whew, goddamn, see?
I didn't know that until
she was,
later
so she was,
on.
Uh-huh. No, so I'm saying, so that means she was scouting. She was scouting you out for an opportunity,
yeah.
and you didn't even know.
Yeah, I had no idea.
God
because,
damn.
Because it's a lot of men.
Like, you lucky bastard.
Understand me. We don't get approached like that. Like,
hell no.
And women say we step to them like that. Yeah, also. So you like it doggy style?
Oh, what? Shit.
Can you just get my number first?
Like, right, what? Right.
That's
yeah.
how I feel.
When she
said, so you up there with two women? Like, God damn.
No. Had you grabbing
place?
Yourself, like, could we
I'm
get to know each other first?
Like, I'm in my security uniform. Why are you...
Oh, shit.
Why are you harassing me?
Man. See, I'm not that lucky. I get women
right.
that say... I get women that tell me, I ain't doing that shit.
Okay, I'm going to tell you something about that.
Okay.
And I was told this by women. Numerous
okay.
women.
Mm-hmm.
A woman will try mm-hmm. anything if you're worth it.
That's very true. It all depends on the type of dude you are. If she's really into you and you're really that dude that know how to push, you know, really, like, really take her to those levels, yeah,
yeah.
You can definitely, yeah, that's very true.
What you mean?
That's very true.
I don't
that's
do doggy
true.
Style. I ain't into
yeah.
that. I've never
yeah.
done that before. Okay, please
yeah.
be gentle.
There you go. Exactly. 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 Be telling you why they doing it. Be telling you why they doing it. You know I don't really do this right.
I don't
yeah, okay.
do this type of
no
stuff.
No problem.
Why are you bending over?
This is the first time I ever did this. I don't understand what it is about you. Yeah. I know what it is about me. I know exactly what it is. I know
okay,
exactly
ladies,
what this shit is.
Do not look at me differently after this show, please. I'm just being
shit.
Real.
You can look at me whatever way you want, goddammit. I don't give a damn. I'm going to tell you what it is. Shit. All you need is that right man to bring the freak out of you. Every woman has that
oh, yeah.
man that no matter how long it been since you've seen him, no matter... If he married, if he this, every woman has that one. Maybe some women have two. Man, that can always bring that freak out of them. It
be
just,
like,
and it,
be
yeah,
like, man, nah,
yeah.
I don't do that type of stuff.
Right.
You know what tequila does to me? Hey, give me another tequila.
What? Give me another one. Make it a double. Oh my God. I never looked at nobody like that but my husband. But it's just something about you. Like, oh no. I can't be around you too long. You bring this out of me. When I'm going to see you again? Golden question, bro. Huh?
I'm just saying.
It happens.
Yeah.
It happens, man. Hey. It
it's
really
sometimes
happens.
I'll be like, what?
Yeah.
Did
yeah.
that just happen? Wow. Okay.
I'll be like, damn, word. I'll be like, damn, word. Wow.
And it,
okay.
And to me, I don't know. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's just me. I don't know if you experience this.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be the ones you least suspect.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The ones that just
the goody
goody. Like, yeah, it's that's
the goody goodies. Yeah, the goody goodies. It'd be the goody goodies, the one, the quiet ones, the ones that's all, oh, you know, I would never this, never that. Yeah, the ones that go to church every Sunday and
see,
you know,
why you had to put them in church now?
I wasn't even gonna go there. I'm going there. The ones that go to church every Sunday, be in the club on Saturday, and be getting their freak off on Friday.
I'd be like, wow, that's okay.
Yeah,
right,
it'd be, yeah. Quiet ones, like, let me tell you, it's crazy because, like, see, I was that dude, like, I was the type, and still am, I never liked the woman. I never go after the woman that everybody wants.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, everybody want her. I'm going to go after her friend. I'm going to go after the one over there. Yeah, I always.
I'm different too. Yeah.
I don't go after the, you know, so when dudes be talking about, oh, yeah, yo, man, I was with Shante last night, man. Oh, my God, you know, man, she this, that, you know how Shante is and this and that. I'll be that dude that be sitting over there like, word. Well, I'm saying, you with Shante, that's what's up. But, you know, I was over there kicking it with Janine. And they be like, Janine? Like, what the fuck you
for
with
real?
Janine?
You talking about Janine I'll be with like, the cold glasses, bro?
Well, it be like Janine. You talking about slim Janine? Got a little, don't really got, but all quiet, always got her nose in the book. I'll be like, yeah, Janine that got her nose in the book, boy. I'll tell you some things, boy. You know what I mean? Like, that was, that's part
and
of
they be the
fight.
One. You know what I found out? Especially with us guys.
Mm-hmm.
It's certain situations like that niggas not going to talk about.
No.
You don't want nobody to know what the deal is for real.
You keep it on the low.
You know he finna go out. Man, you tell your boys that. What?
I don't never tell. Like, I surprise them. I don't never tell them who. I never tell my boys who I'm going after. They just be surprised when it happened. They be like, hold on, son. You wasn't. I'm like, yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So what happened?
I can't tell you that, bro. I ain't trying to fuck my shit up. I ain't trying to fuck my shit up.
Let me try to further find out. Like, come on,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, yeah.
You know it ain't going nowhere. It's just us, dog.
It's just us. I ain't fucking my shit up. Because then you tell your boy, right? And then next thing you know, your boy trying to holler.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
And then now Janine looking at you crazy because she like, I ain't never get this much attention. You must have said something. I be like, yo, I ain't say shit. I ain't fucking up my shit. I ain't say nothing. I keep it right to myself.
Keep it to yourself. Not cause no problem.
Keep it to myself. That's right. And see,
once
the crazy shit about it is,
gives a sniff of it.
It's over. And see, this where the popular girls or the girls that's, you know, easy girls, this where they get upset because Janine would be the one that'll get wifed up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Be like, what
she'll
is
be the one
now,
to get
bro?
Wifed up. Yup. You wifed up, huh? Hell
man.
Yeah.
I be talking shit. Be mad as fire, boy.
Mad.
Yeah, I know about that. Yeah.
Man. Like, let me tell you, man. You know, one of the craziest things, I got asked on a date, and the shit kind of had me stumped. Like, she asked me, okay, so what is it about you to why you while you still single.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I was like,
I've heard that before too.
I was like, mm-hmm. What is it about me? Like, I just told you about myself and told you, you know, certain situations. And she was like, yeah, I hear that. I understand that. But what is it about you? Like, what is it that you need to improve in yourself to why you're still single?
Why do you always think it's something like that? What?
Man.
But if a woman
I don't know,
is
bro.
Single, it's just all good.
Right.
But as soon as they see you single, it's like,
right.
Something wrong. You ain't got no job.
Right. Right. So you ain't got no job, or you abusive, or well, you got a temper, or you an asshole. Like, yo,
man,
that question had me slumped for a second. I was sitting there like, the first thing that entered my head was like, fuck you talking about, what's wrong with me?
I'm just saying, like, man.
What?
I'm just saying.
What the hell? But you know, but you know what? I had to reflect on that question later. Like, that question stayed in my head after the date, everything. Like, we start kicking it on a regular. That question stayed in my head. I had to reflect on that, and I was like, damn, maybe it is some shit. I need to get my shit right. I'm like, maybe I do need to get some things right.
And you be questioning this shit, like, for real.
Word.
Like, what is it?
That had me. And you know, I go front because that question stayed in my mind and it had me stumped. It had me feeling her more because I'm like, damn, she got me questioning myself. I'm like, damn, it had me into her. I was into her more.
Yeah.
That was that mental shit, man. That was that fucking mental shit. She got
I'm
in my head.
You, dog. Like,
she got in my head. Oh God, man. Shit is crazy though, but women know how to do it, man. They know how to get in your head, man.
That's for real.
They know how to get in your head, man, for real. Damn,
women
see
do
we
shit. They do shit sneaky, bro.
Oh yeah, they chess players, bro.
You don't even be on that. You don't even be on that like that. I ain't thinking about nothing. And then you just start sucking a straw a certain way and looking at you. Like, why are you
God.
Doing that? Why are you doing that, man?
Why are you doing that?
It's not even...
Why?
What? Really?
Right.
You got to stick your tongue out?
Right. Come on, really? Yeah. Like, I don't understand. Like, why you playing with me like that? Like, why are you playing mind games? Like, you know that's a mental thing.
Man. And they say they don't do that. Like, everything...
No, they do, man. Women play mind games, man, and they the best at it. They the best at it, bro. Like, let me tell you something. The one woman that can always get in a man's mental is his woman. Your woman always know how to get in your mental, bro. Like,
absolutely.
No matter, it's crazy. Like, no matter how much you try to block it, they be playing that Jedi mind trick, man, on you, man. It should be having you fucked up. Like, your whole day could be going good, right? Your whole day could be going good. You could be popping tags, you fresh to death, you know what I'm saying? You got money in your pocket, you feeling good, looking good. Your woman will call you on some bullshit,
man.
Fuck your whole day up. Fuck your whole day up. Your whole
she
day
mad.
Fucked up.
She mad because you were smiling. What is,
right,
why
you mad?
I was smiling.
For no reason.
What
no
smiling?
Reason at all. Right. It'll just be some shit that should have fucked your whole day up. Your whole day fucked up.
Bruh.
Whole day fucked up. You mad for no reason. You mad, and you don't even know why you mad. Because
don't
you were just feeling good. You know. This is
you
crazy, man.
A mouthful, bro.
Word, bro. And you be trying to shake it. Like, you try to shake it. You try to be like, man, fuck that. You start talking to yourself. Man, fuck that, man. Listen, please, listen. I ain't letting her fuck with me, man. I was having a good day, man. I'm over here, this and that, man. Popping bottles, man. Pocket full of money. Man, nigga, fuck that.
Nigga, you bad.
Man, that pep talk, yo, Gator, that pep talk will last for 10 to 15 minutes. After that shit, you back soaking. Like, this is bullshit, man. What the fuck, man? Why she tripping? Like, I ain't do... What the hell, man? Like, I don't get it.
I thought it was just me. It ain't me.
Nah, bro. Nah, bro, it ain't just you, man. And you know, and you know what to stop that shit? The minute she call you back and she be like, hey, baby, you know, I was tripping, babe. You know I love you. Now you back happy. Now your dumb ass back happy now.
You fell in the trap.
You happy go lucky now.
You damn trap. You don't even remember it now.
You don't even remember that shit.
Bleeding all over the damn place.
All over. Don't realize. She just played the Jedi mind trick with your ass, man.
Bro.
You don't even realize the shit. Now your dumb ass talking about, yeah, baby, I miss you too. Uh-huh. Yeah, okay, I can't wait to see you. Your dumb ass, man. You don't realize what she just did to you.
I'm just saying, man. It's a damn shame, man.
As strong as we are mentally weak. We are mentally weak, man. That's just sad.
I'm sitting over here thinking about how many times that shit worked on me. Like, what the fuck?
Right. That shit had you feeling stupid, man. You think like, damn, I really let her fuck up my day.
Bruh. I'm talking about the whole day was good.
The whole day, uh-huh.
5 minutes. Nigga, you bad at the world. And don't know why.
And don't know why.
Oh. Hello?
Damn.
What you want, mom?
Right. You flipping at people that ain't got nothing to do with it. People that don't even know what the hell going on in your life.
Bruh.
Somebody talking about, hey, Gator, what's up? Yo, you seen that game last night? What game? I ain't watched no damn game. I ain't got time for no game, man. Life ain't a game, all right? That's the problem. Y'all playing life ain't a game. You playing games, man.
Y'all play
life is not a game. Serious, man. Play too much, man. Should be worrying about what's going on in the world. Man, you worry about these damn games.
Man.
Yo. It's fucked up, man. That's just crazy.
And they know they be doing it, too. They
hell
know
yeah.
It. I think they
hell
be taking
yeah.
points, dog. I think they set up, like, go back in the other room and write that shit down. Yeah.
Yeah.
Three times in 5 minutes.
Yep. Exactly. Exactly.
Let me go make him smile. Damn,
let me write.
I was just playing, babe.
Serious. I'm sorry.
We can't be talking to your mom like that.
We so damn weak.
You want something to eat? Yeah, what you got?
Right. What you got, babe? Well, you guys, all right. Your ass sitting there all stupid. Hell, man. God damn, boy. That's a damn
room.
Shame.
Go in the other room, come back with lingerie on. Oh.
Right.
You didn't forget what happened.
You forgot, right? You forgot that she fucked up your whole day. You forgot. She come in the room with something nice, skimpy on in front of you, give you a kiss. You forgot that she just fucked up your day. Now you all baby. Damn, you looking good. But you know, that shit don't work the other way. Because when we try to do that shit to them,
nah.
We try to do that shit to them. Don't that shit don't work. They be like, don't touch me. Be like, what? Babe, I'm trying to make up. No. I ain't ready to make up. You know what you did. And you be like, damn. Now you fucked up.
Man.
You try. It don't work.
3 days.
It don't work.
Bro.
We can't do that shit,
house,
man.
Nigga. You in the doghouse. You didn't forget what happened 3 days ago. Nah, I'm still mad at you. What the
I'm still right. You like, know? Yo. That shit happened last week. You still mad? Like, what the hell? Like, come on now. Like, you start thinking like, that shit don't work.
Y'all got something.
It don't work,
that.
Man.
Because if you messing us up mentally for real, because then we'd be thinking stuff like,
yo, man,
what did I do?
We be fucked up. Right.
What I do for real? Did I cuss her mama out?
Right. You start thinking about everything like, fuck. You like, damn, she's still mad. It's been a week. Like, hold on, like, what else did I do? Like, did
you
I do something else? Like,
you don't even remember what happened because it didn't happen.
You don't even remember, yo. Let me tell you something. Our memories is so short. If your woman mad at you for a week, 9 times out of 10, you forgot what she mad about.
I'm just
you
saying.
Forgot. You like, yo, I don't even remember what we was arguing about. Like, oh, you still mad?
And then they get just mad started, about that.
Right. That started another argument. Oh, so you really don't know what got me mad? Oh, so it wasn't important to you. It wasn't that important to you, huh? That just proves my point, what I was saying. You be like, damn.
What was
you be like,
saying?
Damn. What right. That's what you think. You thinking like, what do you say? Like, what are you saying? Like, okay, you know what? You know what, babe? Nah, I remember. Okay, look. Listen, you start
just making
up.
Those shit. Start making those shit. So you get up
shit.
Out. I'm just
word.
Like, I'm sorry. I didn't
Yo.
Mean to cuss your mama out. Wait, you cussed my mama out? Oh, that wasn't it.
Nah, that wasn't it? Oh, shit, damn. Nah, see, what happened was I didn't really curse out. See, she just said something, I took the wrong way, and we disagreed, but we agreed to disagree. Like, it wasn't really like
phone.
That,
man. Now she on the phone calling your mama, her mama.
Right.
The fact.
Right. Now her and mama is ganging up on your ass, and you sitting there with the stupid face, because you like, damn, what the fuck?
Say what you said just a minute ago. My mama on speaker.
Oh, my God. Yo. Oh, my God, man. It's crazy. And they they so good at it, bro. Like, that shit just be having us all fucked up, man. It's like, it's bad, man.
Bro, I'm just
it's
saying.
Bad. It's bad, man. It's bad. It's bad, bro.
Just be stuck, man. I remember how many times I didn't went through that, man. It's just
no,
playing with
you.
Your mind. Just mess your mind all up.
Bro, you be all fucked up. Like, you be like, damn, like, really? Like,
bro.
Yo, bad. They good at it, man. They know how to get in our minds, man. They get in our minds, man. Once they in our minds, it's a wrap, bro. It's a wrap.
I'm telling you, it's, man.
Oh, God.
I'm sitting here reminiscing, like.
Yeah. Like, ain't this some
that.
Bullshit? This some bullshit. Like, yo. You be like, what the fuck?
I'm telling you.
Yeah, bro.
Y'all can't be
mastermind.
And they won't let us off the hook. It don't matter what you do.
Nah, it don't matter.
So
think
you
about
remember
it
what happened?
Right. You ain't getting off the hook until they ready to let you off the hook. And the thing about it is, it ain't happening when you want it.
Man.
It's not happening.
I think that women have meetings, dog.
They have what?
They be having meetings, man.
Oh, hell yeah.
They all come together in a meeting.
They be having conference calls, man. Word.
Certain places. And be like, yo, what's up, ladies? Welcome
Word.
To another meeting of the Women Hate Men Club. Let me tell y'all what happened last week with me and Joe. Now try this on your man.
Right. They be comparing notes and shit. Coming to the conference call with thumbtaps and shit and highlighters. Like, okay, yeah, I'm going to try this shit. Oh, yeah, so this what you did? How did that work?
Man. The Women Hate Men Club.
And look, our dumbass club be a whole bunch of men sitting around not knowing what the fuck is going on.
Hey, so is Janet still mad?
She's still mad,
bro. It's been a
damn.
She still ain't tell me what I did.
She ain't say nothing.
That's how
I'm like, word, that's exactly how I should go. We be sitting there comparing, not know. We be sitting there comparing how much, like who know the least amount of shit with some liquor and some roll up, and like, listen, man, fuck it, throw the game on, pour me a drink. It's some bullshit, some real bullshit. Oh my God, man,
bruh.
I don't know. This is what it is, man.
Oh,
love
man,
them. Hey, can't live with them, can't live without them.
Man, they be wondering why we ain't coming home.
Nigga be right? scared. We be at the house. We just be sitting in the car yeah. for about 15, 20 minutes. Like,
hell yeah. When you know you done fucked out. Up and your woman mad at you. You know you fucked up, your woman mad at you, man. You take the long way home. You be like, fuck that. I'm doing the speed limit. I'm stopping at every light. Because I know she pissed right now. She pissed. Listen.
Man.
Proceed with caution. You come, what's the first thing you do? You come in the house, and if she's sleeping, you go over there and see if she really sleep.
You don't even walk in the house like you used to. You know, you walk in the
hell
house,
no.
you been at work, your chest
right.
all out like, yeah, I did a good job today. Nigga come peeking around the door.
Right. You walk in the house peeking like, yeah, she pissed. Let me walk in here like...
There's a trash taken out. Let me get the trash real quick.
Yeah. let me get that trash.
That's when we start doing all kind of little
work.
Oh, dang. You know, dirt in it. Don't worry about it. I get it. I'm going to sweep this
up. You know what?
I'm going to sweep this up real quick.
Right. I'm going to cook dinner. You know, I'm going to take the dog for a walk. Matter of fact, I think the car needs to be washed. I'm going to wash the car, you know, a couple of errands I got to do. Like, yo, babe, you need anything? You good? You sure? All right. You know, so you start thinking of shit to do. You like, the tension be tight.
Man,
the tension be tight.
You,
and it's like, they be sitting there like, they don't give a damn. They be sitting there like, you sitting there like, shit, like. They be sitting there like, huh, nigga, whatever. They get on the, you know what's crazy? They'll get on the phone with their girlfriends and all that, be laughing, kicking at everything. And
crack it up.
They get off the phone, straight stone face. You be like, what the fuck? Yo, you
that
was just happy on the phone. Like,
that nigga
you be like,
wow, he don't know what's
right.
He's
you be thinking you
around.
Can slide your way in there because, oh, she happy on the phone. She stop and
like,
give you that. She give you that death stare.
Yeah, girl, he's sneaking around.
Right.
That nigga then took the trash out.
Right. He like, oh shit. He be like, yo. Be like, yo. Remember the last 3 weeks? His ass was supposed to rearrange the closet. Bet that shit done now. That whole closet done. Every all that junk is out there. Yeah. His ass know he fucked up. Man, you be on straight narrow, man. I don't know, man.
That's just hilarious.
It's the way it is, man. It's the way it is, man.
And we let him get away with it, too.
Yeah, we let him get away with it. We can't get away with that shit, though.
Hell no.
We damn sure can't get away with that shit. We can't get away with that shit.
Man, we do that junk. See, it's a wrap.
See, this is all where that saying came from. Happy wife, happy life. Because if
yeah.
the wife is mad, the whole kingdom is fucked up.
Man.
Oh, my God, bro. It's crazy.
Man.
Bro.
Insanity.
Yo, man. Crazy, bro. But, oh, man. I guess we done come to another closed edition of the Man Cave.
Ladies, don't y'all be tripping. I don't want
don't
no
be tripping tonight.
On no BS. No.
Well, hey, like I said, like I always say, we done chopped it up. We done talked about how a man is, you know, if he's really into the relationship or... if you're just convenient. We done broke it down in two different scenarios. We done spoke about, you know, relationships from a man's point of view. We done spoke about mind games, how women play on us and how we fall victim to it. We done chopped it up about a few things in the cave, you know. Another crazy wild edition, but Tone, we know you was busy tonight, brother, so you know it's all good. Signing them checks,
yeah,
man.
Yeah,
Tone,
yeah,
get them
yeah,
endorsements.
Yeah. Get that money.
So, get that money, but Gator, you want to talk to the audience, let them know a few things so we get up out of here.
I'm just saying, make sure y'all check out the Man Cave. We everywhere now, baby.
Yes, sir.
Hey, we all over the place. Anywhere you can listen to a podcast, y'all go check out the Man Cave. And man, this one's a good here. I know I'm gonna get some mail.
Oh yeah, we gonna get it. We gonna get it, bro. But yo, we welcome it all. Send all inquiries, all questions, topics you want to talk about. Send it to tdrthemancave@gmail.com. I just want to thank all the listeners for tuning in. You know, you always going to get a man's point of view about all topics in life in the Man Cave here. Now, I'm your host, Kyle Williams. Like Gator said, you can listen to the Man Cave and you can listen to any show on Tone Deaf Network on all, you know, major platforms, Spreaker, Spotify, iTunes, Apple Music, iHeartRadio. You know, we all over, you know, so
no doubt.
Without you, it would be no us. We appreciate you listening every week. So once again, it's the Man Cave. I'm your host, Kyle Williams. My host, Gator. Shout out to Tone and Fresh, you know. They couldn't be in the office today, but we'll catch them on the next go around. And peace, everybody. Y'all have a good night.
It's a natural.